Fabric materials are quite easy to create with the help of the Fresnel Ramp procedural. In this video, we will learn how to create basic and satin fabric materials. Before we even start creating the materials, we first need to understand how the Fresnel Ramp procedural works. Fresnel Ramp applies a gradient based on the angle between a surface and the camera as seen in this example. We can visualize this by adding the Fresnel Ramp to the diffuse channel. Low and high colors define the gradient that will be applied to the surface. The distribution of the intermediate colors of the gradient can be modified with the index of refraction and exponent values. Let's start with a basic fabric material from scratch. To start with, we will create a basic layer and apply a bitmap to the diffuse channel. We will also load the corresponding normal map to the normal channel and switch from bump to normal. What's left is to change the tiling of the textures. The next step is to add a procedural layer on top of the bitmap in the diffuse channel by selecting Mix Width and select Procedural. Click on the procedural type list and switch from Perlin Noise to Fresnel Ramp. We will leave the default settings as they are and change the blending mode of the Fresnel Ramp layer from Multiply to Additive with a click on the icon. We can now control the effect of the Fresnel Ramp by changing the percentage of the layer's weight. Here is how the Fresnel Ramp affects the material when the weight ranges from 0 to 100%. For a satin material, we need to follow the same steps except for the blending mode of the Fresnel Ramp layer. In this case, we need to keep the blending mode set to Multiply and use the index of refraction value to control the falloff of the highlighted areas. Here you can see how index of refraction affects the material when we set values from 1.1 to 1.6. One last thing that's worth mentioning is the back face material support. Thea for SketchUp considers the material that has been applied to the back faces of a surface. In this scene, light green indicates the back faces of the surface. If we select the surface, you will notice that we have applied two different materials on both front and back faces. We can see the result by starting interactive rendering.